Caitlyn Jenner.
Caitlyn Jenner, who you know is Kris Jenner's ex-husband, wife.
Stepdad, now ex-stepmom. Yeah.
Yes. So she will be named champion of Israel and the LGBTQ rights by the World Values Network at the Jewish Value Awards Gala in New York this March. So Caitlyn Jenner is not Jewish, if you all guessed, but being recognized for advocacy and support for Israel, she's made a point of highlighting Israel's acceptance and tolerance for the LGBTQ community, which I totally get.
So very cool. I mean, a very cool honor. I mean, she's been very active.
Yeah, anything.
I can't remember. I feel like she was here for one of the Pride events. Maybe a few years ago.
Maybe I think so.
If my memory serves me correctly, but if not, I'm wrong. But
I know that that Israel is a very open. That's at least what I feel here.
Yeah,
we're very open
absolutely.
With the LGBTQ community and their rights and everything.
So good. Well deserved.
Cool. Yes.
All right. So Kulula.
Yes, I love to sing. I'm sure you do as well. Well, none of us all sing in tune, but here we have an opportunity to be part of something big. So a new song was released online today by a group called Kululam, which is an internationally recognized movement in bringing people from all religion, race, culture together. So they released a new song by Avram Tal, an Israeli singer. Let's have a look at this. It's beautiful.
Wow, okay. Very cool, and there's a purpose behind it, yeah?
Yes, yes. So the idea came from Canada, actually, and was brought to Israel, and it's to get people to come together from all kinds. I mean, they want to spread the movement. There were a couple thousand, I know in this song, there were about 2,000, 3,000 people. And to just stop everything for a few hours and sing, you know, to create a communal experience.
Absolutely.
For everyone who enjoys singing. And actually, they did a song by the Imagine Dragons, you know, A Believer.
Mm-hmm.
A Believer, that song, which Imagine Dragons shared to their video on Facebook, which got a lot of attention.
Amazing.
So this thing is growing.
I mean, listen,
and growing.
It's such a great cause. You get people singing, it's just energetically, like the whole meditation thing.
Yes,
it just energetically kind of transforms you. It doesn't.
Yeah.
And I love that they actually have captioning and they have it for,
yes,
you know, the hearing impaired.
Yes, exactly.
Marley Matlin will be happy. We're going to tag her on Twitter. She's always pro Israel and things that are make sure that it's universal to everyone.
Yes. So
okay, serving competition in Netanya.
Right.
Thank goodness they actually had waves. I mean, you're taking
a risk having an event. Amazing waves. I think they know this pretty much ahead of time. So this week is the World Surfing League's World Surf Competition, which is taking place in Netanya. Of course, surfers and spectators came from all over the world to watch. And the way it works is the league, they surf all over the world in different locations.
Mm-hmm.
And then each location is ranked in points. So each location gets points. And then they look at all the points and see who came first. Israel got 3,000 points. Apparently, that's a lot. I'm not sure where we ranked, but it's a high number. And, you know, it's world recognition, amazing waves, and cute boys.
It's great. And I see that I was reading the notes, there was a 15-year-old who's like becoming a phenom.
Yeah.
I love the surfing culture here.
Yeah.
I used to live by Azarekan where all the surfers are, and, you know, growing up in Malibu where there's real waves, but it's like
prohibitive.
I will not go in the water there because the waves are too big.
It's scary, yeah. So here you would think there aren't that many waves, but there are. And
there
apparently there's a whole community.
Salt culture here,
yeah.
Surf culture.
Yeah.
Very cool. Okay, wine
surf
on the vine.
Mine.
Instead of planting trees back in my bat mitzvah days, getting a bond to plant a tree that.
Things have changed. So Wine on the Vine is a nonprofit organization partnering with Israeli vineyards, wineries, and NGOs. There's going to be an evening of wine tasting. This is totally your thing. Live music and art auction to support Israel and revitalize the connection with the culture. So they're selling grapevines on Israeli vineyards, and people choose which NGO they want to support and get their own grapevine.
How
Can
cool
you
is
imagine?
That? But then do we know, like, is it, yes, it's going to charity, but do you, like, get first dibs on once the vine becomes ready for
ready
wine?
Ready for wine? I don't know.
I don't know.
I think they should take it.
Or we could come up with our own name and our own, like.
Right. For our little section.
A little grapevine.
But it's a great concept. Another way to just spread the culture of Israel.
Spread the love and all of the good wines coming from here. All right. Veganuary.
Good. You said it right.
Veganuary.
Veganuary started abroad in the UK.
With a picture of this guy.
Yeah. First rule of vegan compliments. Look at this. These are great.
So anyway, the Veganuary started since 2014. What they aim to do is encourage people to go vegan for the month of January. So partly due to their efforts, the number of vegans have really grown. This group has been really active. It's endorsed by celebrity chef Jamie Oliver, who promoted it to 7 million Twitter followers. And celebrity vegans include Miley Cyrus, Ariana Grande, Jessica Chastain, Lewis Hamilton, and Woody Harrelson. So Israel is also now part of this. It's very new.
Of course,
new.
We know per yes. capita. We
come a little
up
bit
there.
Late. But late in the game, but we're there.
Better late than never.
Exactly. So there's many workshops and classes on making yummy vegan food, from healthy Indian food workshop this weekend to Rusty's Nuts. Remember Rusty's Nuts that was here? So she's doing a vegan no-bake class for quick, delicious, healthy treats. All easy to make. It's basically making veganism fit into your lifestyle. So even if you're not fully vegan,
it is a very
vegan,
clever way. People will try to realize it's not so bad, and that's how you get people to become vegan.
Exactly.
Right?
Yes.
All right. Thank you. We're out of time.
Thanks. Well,